My name is Amolnir Goodkarn, the CEO of Patient Prism. And we have in our studios Alex Nudel, who's the founder of RevenueWell. Welcome, Alex.
Thank you, Amol.
And we're having some great conversations about all things dentistry. And Alex is the master communicator. He's developed a system in RevenueWell that allows dental offices to communicate effectively with their patients and re-engage them into making the decisions that are right for their health. One of the questions I get asked a lot about is one of the biggest problems in dentistry, which is no-shows.
Yeah.
Talk to us about what your approach at RevenueWell has been in solving one of the biggest problems, especially in the DSO space, which is no-shows.
Yes. So for years,
right,
for more than 20 years, we've been taught that if a patient leaves without a future appointment, that they're not your patient.
Hmm.
So we only consider patients that are on the schedule as actual patients. And that's what makes our schedule predictable.
Okay.
So many different tactics have been taught to the nice people at the front desk,
yeah,
to pressure somebody into making an appointment when they're not ready.
Sure.
So if you look at the way that they schedule,
okay,
and the verbiage that they use, more than likely is, let's just put you onto the schedule.
Right.
And we'll either connect with you a month before, or we'll send you a reminder, or we'll move you if we have to. So I think that 80% of the schedule is solid.
Right.
People that actually want to be there,
sure,
and that want to stay with their hygienist and on a certain day that they have off or whatever it is.
Sure.
So that's the problem number one, is that 20% of your schedule,
sure,
in the DSO market, maybe 40 to 50%,
more, yeah. Yeah.
Is unpredictable. What happens in a no-show, it's somebody that doesn't show up for their appointment.
Sure.
And how do you deal with that?
Sure.
So RevenueWell has many tools to help the practice identify these people, and the algorithm that you set up for yourself,
sure,
as much information as you have to confirm patients or remind patients about their appointment, maybe 2 weeks out.
Sure.
Maybe another 2 days out, and maybe another 2 hours out.
Right.
And so the 2 hours is the one where you get the biggest response of, I'm not coming.
Okay.
So RevenueWell imports from the practice management system an ASAP list.
Okay.
These are people that are trying to get in,
right,
sooner if possible.
Sure.
But because they didn't pre-schedule their appointment, it's now much later than they anticipated.
Sure.
And if you train the staff to say, hey, if we do have an opening,
mm-hmm,
we will get in touch with you right away and help you achieve your dream of coming to our office,
right,
and getting a prophy or a perio maintenance done sooner.
Right.
And so we have an ASAP list that we go through and are able to text, email, and actually make robocalls,
right,
out of RevenueWell and tell the patient that we have an opening at this day, this time.
Okay.
And if you would like it, first come, first serve basis. And so let's say we send it out to 20 patients,
sure,
10 patients, 5 patients,
sure,
that we know that are looking to come in sooner.
Sure.
And the other 3, 4, 5 we can't put on.
Right.
So we get to open up our schedule and say, what do we have tomorrow or the day after as an opening so we can bring those people in?
So it allows you another opportunity to connect with that patient who has a probability of not showing up.
Correct. Or they say, hey, we just can't make it.
Okay.
I'll give you for instance. I had a nice lady tell me the other day, she goes, Nudel, I don't have anybody to pick up my dog from the groomers.
Yeah.
To me, this is an emergency. I have dogs, I understand.
Right.
So I was able to reschedule her,
right,
and then go to the ASAP list.
Yeah.
Now, most of the ASAP lists sync with the practice management software,
sure,
to where RevenueWell allows you to create one. And now I call it the hot list of people that are really trying to get in sooner, and we can break them down. Are they there for restorative or hygiene?
Sure.
How much time did they need? What procedure are they going to be doing? And I'm able to say, here's a patient that last minute canceled, but I have another 2 patients that are looking to get into the doctor to do XYZ or to the hygienist, and we've been really successful with that.
So by kind of looking at these ASAP or hot lists, you're able to identify opportunities for patients to come in at a different time possibly and offer them a more convenient option, and that kind of prevents people from not showing up. What about new patients? You've talked to thousands of practices.
Yes.
Why do new patients not show up?
For many reasons.
Right.
For many reasons. We can talk about reasons all day.
Sure.
But here's what I found.
Okay.
Is that if we're able to send out a welcome package to those patients that schedule right away.
Right.
And include the forms that they need to fill out. And showcase our office with a YouTube video or something like that.
Nice.
And introduce the real people that are going to be seeing you.
Excellent.
And stress of how important it is to keep that appointment. We're seeing numbers that are really through the roof. If they fill out forms, 95-98% of them are actually showing up.
And you can easily accomplish that through the campaigns section of RevenueWell.
So we have a welcome packet.
Right.
So anytime when somebody goes onto the schedule, immediately goes out. Years ago, we would schedule somebody 3-4 days out on purpose so we can send them a packet.
Right.
That was very expensive. And then it was never up to date with email. The second you have a change, I have a new piece of technology, we have a new person at the front desk, whatever it is, we can modify it immediately and send the most current information out. The welcome packet is unbelievable.
So RevenueWell actually addresses both the no-shows on the existing patient side as well as the new patient side. By the existing patients, you kind of create hot lists to kind of connect with them and offer them better slots, but through the welcome and through campaigns, you're able to instantly build a rapport with a patient that has never seen you before.
Correct.
And that and you make that very, very easily. So this is fascinating. It's the first time I've gotten a good answer for no-shows in this business. So thank you so much.
Amal, it's my pleasure.
Thank you.
Thank you.